of our channel, which is based on explanation of chapter 1, A Letter to God, A First Flight. It is very productive and very useful, especially for class 10 students. Don't forget to give your valuable feedback in the comment box, as it will help me to know about which content you want my next video. So let's
start our story, A Letter to God. The story, A Letter to God by G.L. Fuentes, depicting unwavering faith of a farmer in God. It begins with a farmer named Lencho expecting for a rain shower to nourish his field of corn. Lencho was lived on the top of the hill. He is confident that his harvest is going to yield him huge profit, just like it does every year. He is very honest person. To his utmost excitement, rainfall did happen, but sooner it turned into a hailstorm, destroying his entire crop field. When the farmer Lencho saw this type of destruction in his field, he got very upset. The damage posed a threat to the family survival, as their entire livelihood was depend on the year's produce. Lencho was not able to collect any fruits and vegetables for their family. Although the family, disheartened, had robust belief in the Almighty, Lencho, despite having worked day and night at the field, knew how to write and thus decided to write a letter to God explaining his situation and asking for help. He went to town to post his letter addressed to God. The letter, on being noticed by the postmaster, at first amused him, but then motivated him want to do something for the farmer so as to keep his immense belief intact. He contributes from his salary and collects money from his colleagues and friends who willingly contributed for an act of charity. To his dismay, he could not only collect 70 pesos, which he wrapped in an envelope to make it seem like a reply from the DT. On having found the letter, the Lencho is not at all shocked, but instead he gets angry on finding that the amount is less than what he had expected from the God. He against writing a letter to God conveying his disappointment and distrust in the employees of the post office who he thought had stolen the remaining amount.